Guess who's back? Steve. Still doing that shit, Andre?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Check me out. It's still Dre Day. AK. Though I've grown a lot, can't keep it home a lot. Cause when I frequent the spots that I'm known.
For the century's final championship begins today as number 3 battles number 4 in a game that will identify only one as a title contender.
I think we're nuts. I think this is what this team wants. We want a tough team to start off.
Game day kicks off its 99 campaign from Happy Valley now.
Center of Pennsylvania at the foot of Mount Nittany, a special setting for college football. Folks have made the pilgrimage from all corners of the state. It's a beautiful autumn-like day. We are across to the old gray battleship of Beaver Stadium. You know, school started Monday. I think you can tell here, though. The folks are thinking football. They're thinking Sears Trophy and national championship. Welcome to College Game Day. Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit, Tony Barnhart will join us. Great to see you guys in one of the best.
This has been a presentation of ESPN.
The base of Mount Nittany becomes a city unto itself, a perfect setting for another season of college football on ABC. The professorial legend of Nittany Valley, where his linebacker U has another star pupil, majoring in destruction with a minor in intimidation in hopes of returning Penn State to the head of the nation's class. Today, the lesson toughens against a Heisman hopeful whose name fits the trophy like an old dust cover. It's the first test of the season lying ahead as the Wildcats invade the Lions' homeroom in Happy Valley. It's the 10th annual Pigskin Classic presented by the Principal Financial Group, and what a way to start the year. Number 3, Arizona, against the number 4, Nittany Lions of Penn State.
Play action. Thompson sets up, plenty of time. Deep middle, got Fields inside the 20, and he broke away. Sophie Fields, touchdown. The tailback. Smith, gonna go deep on the first play, and got his man across the 45, out near the 48-yard line.
The 47.
Play fake to Kennedy. Smith, the sidearm toss, complete. Got a man in the secondary. It's North cut again, and he weaves his way all the way down to the 25-yard line. So Arizona striking back. Mark McDonald to try a 40-yard field goal, and he missed it. Shoffy Fields, another end around, and he broke free. Shoffy Fields into the secondary. He's gone.
For Penn State, regardless of what happens here.
And they block the football. Penn State's going to have great field position, in fact. Eric Sturdivant, I think, is the guy that got to it, number 58.
5-1 game against Michigan State. They're trying to make it 17-0, Nittany Lions. And both played quarterback. It's Thompson right now, wants to throw a swing. To Johnson on the run with nobody in front of him. Johnson cuts back inside the 40, picks up his blockers. He might go. Touchdown, Penn State. Straight up the middle is Aaron Harris. Stiff arm. A great move to the outside. Touchdown. Touchdown. Omar Easy for the score. It's Mills. Arizona. 41-7, Penn State. Coming.
On College Avenue, thoughts turn to Bourbon Street and the national championship game 4 months from now. It's a long way off, but you can't blame the Penn State fans for thinking that. This is a more impressive offensive performance than any of the 12 last year. The defense was smothering. Arizona had to hear choruses of overrated all afternoon, and you know the players agree. That's the case.
When the offense scores 41 points, we won't lose the game if the offense can score 41 points every game.
I'm embarrassed for this team, for my family. Dig down deep, and I don't want this to ever happen again.
Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit, join me. Tackling was poor. They got out game plan, out executed, out everything.
Well, really, this was not a good day, Chris, for the Arizona Wildcats. Now, they looked good in the pregame warm-up, but this was the highlight of the game for Arizona right here. Now, we came out and looked really good in the pregame. Like I said, they went out to the middle of the coin, and this is what they won. The only thing they won all day was the flip of the coin right there. Then after that, it was all downhill, and the fat lady started to sing in the first quarter. Forget about it. They were bombed.
So much for that speed of the Pac-10.
Yeah,
didn't they?
Forget it.
You are looking live at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey. On an August afternoon, a sellout crowd is here for the 17th annual kickoff classic, matching Miami of the Big East against Ohio State of the Big Ten.
Will Fulcher will be in when they need a fullback, as he is now upset to the left. Second down and 12. Jackson sprints to the right. Alley Jackson breaks free. Jackson. Here comes Wiley again on a cutback through the middle. Wiley to a hole. Wiley's free. 45. Foot race. Reggie Germany with him. Blades kicks him out at the 10-yard line. Al Blades.
He will attempt this field goal.
Buckeyes are on the scoreboard. So they fail in a first and 10. Wideout. He's off to the short side of the field. Kelly, fumble, hit from the blind side. Diggs got him. And the Buckeyes have a first down at the 6-yard line.
Now the Buckeyes with another touchdown opportunity. Here's Wells, and he is jumped on by Dan Morgan. Fifth crack at that end zone down there.
Got it. Touchdown pass. Mockerman's first scoring strike, and it goes to tight end Steve Wisniewski. The Buckeyes lead it for the first time.
The other outside backer moves up on the right side. Kelly off a play fake. Cheat was in his face, throws it downfield. Santana Moss. Got it.
A brilliant catch by Moss. Inside the 10-yard line. Oh,
second quarter, kicking it from the right hash. Jeff Popovich, the holder. It'll be a 28-yarder for Crossley.
No good. And I go back to the fact that they let the clock run out. We've now had an extra point.
Kelly from the pocket fires. Intercepted.
Intercepted by Mike Clements, the young man who replaced
long field goal attempt. Must be a 44-yarder. No good. The kicking game with a little work to do as the season gets underway. 9-7. Crossland. Returnable. Cross midfield. Clements fumble. Loose ball. Believe the Buckeyes pounce on it. Not serious. And then Chris is like, fumble by Belisari, pulling away. So Dean Blevins' note from the field, right on the spot, as Belisari fumbles and it goes over to Miami.
First, in case you just joined us, play fake to him. Now Kelly looking. They got him wide open.
Oh, complete. Inside the 10-yard line. Fulcher, the fullback,
Jackson, great catch, and they get it. No one was on Jackson. Had they been there when he touched the ball, Bella would have half still ahead of us. They fake Davenport. Kelly going to go long down the middle. Bit of a wobbler here. Santana Moss against Clemens. Santana runs to it and swings free in a foot race with Berry. Moss, touchdown, Miami. Holy cow. You thought someone was going to go in motion.
They only have 10 men.
It's 10 against 11. Kelly does it himself again. The automatic. Final 6 seconds. Lockerman, the quarterback for the Bucks, gonna fire it deep. Germany, and it's picked off. Intercepted by the Canes as time runs out. Mike Rump from Delaware. Kelly gonna throw it. Hit on the blind side. Ball. Ohio State jumps on it at the 31-yard line. Against the 4-3, here comes Wiley. Fumble! Recovered Miami! Michael Barreau from North Miami Beach falls on the
hole. Down and 10.
Good protection. Under throw. Intercepted. Picked off on the far side by Plummer. The best of the 24-yarder. Made a 23-yarder in the opening quarter. And now he has the 24-yarder. So he's 2 of 3. Rambo been shut out here today. Muckerman fires middle. Grab. Beautiful catch at the 25-yard line. Missed it too. 7:15 to go. The Buckeyes with a life. But they on the field is Germany, and Mockerman looks for it. Bad pass, intercepted. Germany had not turned around. I do see a penalty flag. Miami 23, Ohio State 12. Superb coaching job by that gentleman right there. And the swagger returns.
Fine, turn the heat up. Better believe we gon' shine. Make your body wine, baby. The pleasure is all mine. To my people, who you regulating the dance floor? Better step to your business and handle yours. How we do it? Making your people just wanna bounce and get busy because you know that we always hit you off. What you say? You wondering why you feeling the fall?
The Fighting Irish of Notre Dame opened their season last week. Jarius Jackson danced past Kansas, but he wasn't perfect. The Irish quarterback threw 3 interceptions and raised Michigan's hopes. This year, the guns are reloaded. 2 Michigan quarterbacks are ready for another title run.
Field goal.
Here comes the A-train cutting back and downhill. Still battling all the way to the 25-yard line. He was an express.
Already with a 21-yarder.
This from 35 yards out. And he's 2 for 2. So Jeff Del Verne makes it 6-0. Oh, a beautiful call into round. And Joey Getherall walks into the end zone. A great call.
And bounced a few off helmets.
Third down, hits into the middle of the rope. First down. You talk about a rifle arm. Here's a young man who was a pitcher way back when.
Attempting to regain the lead for Michigan. 37-yard attempt. Tom Brady, the holder. And he does just that. 3 Del Verne field goals. They regain the lead. The blitz is picked up beautifully by the fullback. Oh, what a block. And now Jackson dances to the end zone. Touchdown, Notre Dame. But what a block by Joey Goodspeed, who picked off the linebacker and crushed him. Anthony Thomas. Brady to put it up on first down. He's got Terrell on a cutback. 45. Down at the 48-yard line as the DB slipped. For Shea over there, the left wing. Let's see if they bring him in motion to the middle. Here it comes. And Shea, touchdown, Michigan. So after three field goals, Fisher outside, Hendricks in pursuit. Fumble. Michigan pounces on it. Tommy Hendricks is a little bit of everywhere that time. And Johnson. Play fake. Gonna go deep. Knife. First down inside the 25-yard line. Ty Streets is gone. At the coverage. Del Verne, you can see the distances of the three field goals he's been successful on. He can add a 27-yarder to that total, and I believe he slid it right. He misses. 3 for 3 in the first down. Open man. Beautiful look back to Terrell for another first down.
I think it may have to be settled on the field with the performance.
And score that one for Brady. He put it right on the numbers for David Terrell. Now, a 28-yard attempt. Remember, young man just missed a 26-yarder, hit three in the first half. Got this one right down Broadway, didn't he? Nailed it. And that puts him using the shotgun. Wall of protection all day, overthrew, intercepted. Picked off by Hendricks. A very poorly thrown football. So again, coach telling us that Jeff Del Verne would handle the short attempts. He would use Epstein only on the long ones and the kickoffs. The holder is the quarterback, Tom Brady. After a first and goal inside the 10, good defense by the Irish. And Wolverines strike first. A 21-yard field goal. This is the motion receiver. Driver. Fumble. Michigan indicates they've got it. Let's wait for the official signal. There were a couple of big Irish paws battling to get it back down there on the bottom, but they do not. Michigan. First down and 10. Good pair of hands on Jarvis. Middle's open. Got him. Evans upended at the 28-yard line. But oh, were the Wolverines soft that time. They are going to throw. Shades of Desmond Howard. They'll walk in for a touchdown. Holloway, the receiver.
To get the instructions.
Well, who knows what they're going to come up with here after that last fourth down call. Jackson sprints, dumps, got it. And those two are huge as he hits Bobby Brown for the two-point conversion with 4:08 to go. Brady to throw. Terrell got it. 5-yard line, first and goal, Michigan. A-Train. The toss. Runs wide. Battles into the end zone for the touchdown. The Irish have spent their timeouts. Deep middle. Nelson's got it. Clock stops. First down. Notre Dame not out of bullets.
Back with a big sack.
Now 31 yards away. Jackson. Middle. Got Nelson.
Nelson, but short of the first down. Clock runs. He's got it down. Can he get it down? Not enough time. Michigan wins it.
Oh, for one more timeout, the Fighting Irish are saying right here.
Gunning this, brother running this, Buffalo soldier. Look, it's like I told you. Any damsel that's in distress, be out of that dress when she meet Jim West. Roughneck, so go check the lawn and by. Watch your step.
Ohio State, Ohio Stadium packed with 94,000 tonight. Script Ohio for only the fourth time in the twilight. The fourth night game in the history of this facility about to square off the Buckeyes and the Bruins. That's the matchup tonight, the Pac-10 and the Big Ten. The Bruins come in 1-0 and ranked 14th ranked Ohio State off to an 0-1 start. Here come the Buckeyes, and the Bruins will be coming out next. Our kickoff in a moment.
Uses the whole field and all the weapons.
Second down and two from the 33, and Bennett comes up tossing it again. Fires, almost intercepted. And now picked up by UCLA, and it's Matt Stanley down the sideline. The Columbus, Ohio natives got a touchdown. 67 yards off a deflected pass, and the fullback takes it all the way to the end zone.
Have you ever seen a walk-on or a fullback run like that? He was running. Take a look, pretty innocent pass, a pass that could have been picked up. Drew Bennett goes from saying, oh my gosh, to go for a touchdown. What a first play. Uses the whole field and all the weapons.
Second down and two from the 33, and Bennett comes up tossing it again. Fires, almost intercepted. And now picked up by UCLA, and it's Matt Stanley down the sideline. The Columbus, Ohio natives got a touchdown. 67 yards off a deflected pass, and the fullback takes it all the way to the end zone.
Have you ever seen a walk-on or a fullback run like that? He was running. Take a look, pretty innocent pass, a pass that could have been picked up. Drew Bennett goes from saying, oh my gosh, to go for a touchdown. What a first play.
In to try a 35-yard field goal. He was one for one in the season opener. Kick on the way, and Griffith is added to the Bruin lead from 35 yards away. UCLA trying to pull a shocker on the road against the Buckeyes of Ohio State. Play action from Ackerman going deep down the middle. Keller, his fullback, is in the clear. And they just do. Ackerman from the shotgun, under pressure. Throws on the run, got it to Wiley. Nice little sidestep inside the 20. Down to the 19 at the 3-yard line. And Wiley in there at the tailback spot gets the pitch, heading to the corner. Wiley, touchdown. The Buckeyes first score.
So they don't have anything in particular in mind to get these guys the ball, Garrett.
Well, they try it here and pull it down. Reggie Germany, he's back to throw to the corner. Rainbow, touchdown. So Belisari comes in and lights up the crowd at the scoreboard. Ohio State. Wiley, left side, follows his blockers, touchdown. That one looked easy.
That one was easy.
Wide receivers.
End around. Freddie Mitchell, a lot of room and a lot of blockers. Mitchell inside the 30, 20, cuts back, and all the way down to a first and goal for UCLA. Melsby, the lone wideout, two tight end set. Deshaun Foster on the carry to the corner, touchdown. The Bruins right back in the football game. And boy, did it get quiet in here in a hurry.
Well, Deshaun Foster rode that ball right into the end zone for 11.
Ackerman, plenty of time. Deep middle, overthrew it, intercepted. Picked off by Strikula. And the guy who walked on made his first start last week and was. Bennett steps up, fires, intercepted by Plummer. He was down, but he caught it. 7:15 left third quarter, second down and three for the Buckeyes. Wiley on a counter, first down and a lot more. Wiley all the way from 43. Stultz missed from 44 against Miami and hit a couple 20-plus yarders. Got a lot of leg into this one.
I don't think so.
Nope. Pushed it to the right. Dave Perry and his group will be looking at that all week.
There's a fumble.
UCLA covers it. They've got it back at the 25. Foster. Play action. Bennett wanting to throw. Lost the handle, and it's covered by Ohio State. He just lost his grip, and Jason. At the 30. Belisari. Nice play fake. Deep down the middle, he's got a man wide open inside the 10 as Wisniewski is huge tight end.
Going the wrong way.
It's the fullback, Martin. Martin. Touchdown. Second down and short. Rambo in motion across the field. And he might come back for the end around and does. Got a great block from his quarterback. Kenyon Rambo stepped out of bounds at the 7-yard line.
Receiver man-to-man outside.
On Rambo, they roll that way, looking to throw, and he does to the end zone. Touchdown. Penalty marker at the 8-yard line, but Gary called it and Belisari delivered it. Let's see what the flag's about. Offside UCLA, touchdown. Ohio State. And 33-yard field goal attempt by Griffith. And the kick up, and they figure they need three somewhere along the line. They get it here.
Right now, Edgerrin James and Ron Dane are going to have to send part of their salary.
Third and nine, Belisari airing it for Germany. Got it!
Wow!
At the 9-yard line.
Way on, they can start to make plays at that wide receiver position.
Westbrook, left side, touchdown! Everybody's joining the party. Jerry Westbrook's a junior. Takes it in from 8 yards out. For you today on ABC. Here's pause, and it is intercepted. Bobcats are looking on in this game tonight going, oh, are you
Jerry
kidding
Westbrook's
me?
Carried.
15 seconds, that's the final play of the game. John Cooper, we showed you those five winningest active coaches. There goes number 180 for John Cooper. And for the 21st straight year, Ohio State wins their home opener. 42-20 is the final tonight over UCLA.
Can't you bounce with me? Bounce with me, with me, with me, with me. Bounce with me, bounce with me. Bounce with me, bounce. Yeah. Can I hit it in the morning without giving you half of my dough? And even worse, if I was broke, would you want me? If I couldn't get you finer things like all of them diamond ring bitches.
Welcome everyone to the Home Depot College Football on CBS Sports as Tennessee and Florida renew their spirited rivalry. Swamp is sold out, as it has been for every home game of the Steve Spurrier era. These 85,000 fans make this the loudest outdoor venue in college football, and that is certainly the case tonight as the defending national champions come a-calling to take on. Johnson throws the pay to Travis Taylor. Out of bounds at midfield.
The left guard making his 33rd career strike today. Man open. Darryl Jackson juggles.
tries to elude Goodrich. Stanley out of the hold of Billy Young, and that kick is good. Martin threw it right into the hands of Alex Brown. The pitch to Jamal Lewis. Big hold. Play from Loudermilk. Martin throws. Complete first down. Eric Parker. Not an automatic first down, and now they're trying to pick it up on the rollout by Martin. He has the first down. He lunges and has a touchdown. What a competitor T. Martin is. And he got an excellent block by Will Barth. Game for Cooper is the kicker. Jeff Chandler took over, and he's been almost flawless ever since. 7-6 Tennessee. In the second quarter, that pass caught. That one's long enough, and it is good. His first catch tonight. Out of the gun, Johnson guns it to the end zone for a touchdown to Darryl Jackson. Graham again breaks into the secondary. Across midfield and down to the 10. Ernest Graham alone back. He stayed in the block. The pass caught by Willis. First down and more. Alex Willis. At a wideout position, they throw to the near side to Rashe Caldwell. Touchdown. Fulmer is on the team. He's now 49 years old. Johnson slipped through a wounded duck, and there's the big break they need from Deion Grant. Back in the game after a Bartholomew also into the game, leading the way for Jamal Lewis, who scores a touchdown. On second and 10, a big hole for Lewis inside the 10. And down into this game. Now Tennessee threatening to get very close. Lewis up and over and in for a touchdown. Putting the ball on the ground. Burr gave him the hook. Johnson going deep, and it is intercepted again. Deion Grant out of bounds. Gillespie, all kinds of room outside. He cut back to stay in bounds. That should do it for the Gators. Johnson takes it in. So Florida, which won five in a row, head-to-head with Tennessee before last year's loss. Will they get six out of seven against the Vols? And if the Vols thought this would be the victory at last at the Swamp that gives them the respect they've been looking for, it won't happen tonight.
John Hoke said he normally is a great sleeper, but he woke up Thursday morning or Friday morning about 4:30 a.m. seeing plays. He said something's up, something's different about this game. He should sleep well tonight because his defense played a great, great football game. And so did Doug Johnson.
But in kissing, could you see yourself with a nigga working harder than 9 to 5?
Miami didn't want to come out first, but Joe Paterno said we're coming out second, so here come the Hurricanes to a standing salute.
Extend to a 9-0 lead with the extra point coming
up. Brown, that was his
Canes get a break at the 34-yard line. Too smart to cut him even when he lost speed. Kelly buys time, fires on the run. Look at that throw. That's what Kenny Kelly can do when he's on his blitzers coming. Kelly steps in. He's on the run. Look at that move. But Kelly is taken down. No, he's not. He breaks the tackle, and he's inside the 15-yard line. He's not done till he's down to the 7. Pulling rabbits out of hats. 18 yards. He was done.
Fumble, Penn State.
Penn State has the ball.
Gets away from another tackle. Hold on to the football. There it comes. Big time hit.
Coaching that particular year. Kelly swings it out. Jackson gets the ball and somehow gets downfield. He's on the way. He's inside the 20 and gets out of bounds.
Does it all.
29-yard attempt. On the way, and he splits him. So the Canes get points late in the second quarter, leading 6. Throw and a catch to the tight end. Tony Stewart is down for a first down to the 5-yard line. McCoo to the 2.
Doesn't matter.
Second and goal. McCoo wide and in, standing up. And Penn State with a perfectly executed opening drive that was ignited. 8th play of the drive. Right back to Jackson with a blocker. He's heading in, and James Jackson takes it the distance. Miami's back in the game, an 18-yard run for a touchdown. From 85 through 94, Kelly dumps it off. He gets McPartland, his big fullback, who doesn't get it off him, but loses the ball. It caroms downfield and goes out of bounds. Kelly takes a look on 2nd and 9. Bails out of trouble for the moment. Fires a long ball. Look at this. It's taken in. Touchdown. Santana Moss on the comeback pattern he beat Ohio State with on a 67-yard scoring play just like that. This was 40 yards. 33. Lob throw. Nicely timed. Down with the ball. Shoffy Fields, and he's ahead for a pick. McCoo cuts back. Open gate. Eric McCoo, what a well-executed play by the Nittany Lions. He's laying it on the line. Every guy, everything he's got, every play. Field goal. Travis Forney knocks it up and through, and the Lions break the tie and build a 20-17 lead with a lot of time left. We saw it all there. Jackson to the outside. The race is on, and he's gone. James Jackson into the end zone. No flags, and the Canes take the lead on a 39-yard touchdown run. Third down, and the Lions need 18. Here comes the rush. Throw. Intercepted. Edward Reed is on the run for Miami. He knows where to go. Here's a marker down. If he goes in, it'll come back, but it will be Miami's ball. To Michigan 15 years ago. They don't play a lot of Big Ten teams. Long ball. There's a guy. It's caught. Shoffy Fields is on the run. A race to the end zone. And Shoffy Fields will win it. He goes in with 1:42 left to play.
Look at the Penn State people on the field. They're going to get called.
No flags. It's a touchdown. Penn State has come from behind on a 79-yard pass play. And they want to double him up. Here's a Kelly looking at him, eludes the rush, fires downfield, intercepted. The ball is picked off. Ascari Adams takes it back, and Penn State will win the game if they can run out the clock with 1:11 left back.
Middle linebacker's coming on a blitz. So's Arrington. Here's Kelly, runs away from trouble. Long ball. Only guy out there is a Nittany Lion, yet another pick. And that will do it.
Right to Baja Joe. To the wall, hit the big play, a 79-touchdown play. Just as, hey, what can you do? Butch Davis said one of the first football books he read when he was in grammar school was the first book Joe Paterno wrote on coaching. That'll do it. Now for Mike Mayock.
Relax and take notes while I take totes of the marijuana smoke. Throw you in a choke, gun smoke, gun smoke. Big He smokes for mayor, the rap slayer, the hooker layer. Motherfucker, say your prayers. Hail Mary, full of grace. Smack the bitch in the face. Take her Gucci bag and her North Face off her back.
Subplots today. How will Wisconsin react after that embarrassing defeat a week ago? And who will play quarterback for Michigan in the second half today? But first, a little history lesson. Back to last year, Wisconsin unbeaten goes into Ann Arbor and the Wolverines spank them. And look at those numbers. It was not even close. Let me welcome in my colleague today, Gary Danielson. Gary, as Paul Harvey might say, let's hear the rest of the story after that game.
Brad, you couldn't be more right about this game. To really appreciate today's game, you have to look back to last year, and not just the game. After the game, there were things said in the papers, and Wisconsin has to live with, even though they went to the Rose Bowl in Ann Arbor, they're calling them a fraud and exposed. And in Ann Arbor, the players are not surprised that they could lose to Cincinnati a week before. This is a team that still has to prove themselves to the Michigan Wolverines, and that's why that focus on Ron Dayne is so right. If he doesn't rush for 100 yards, and he never has, we're going to be swapping golf stories in the fourth quarter.
Well, partner, a year ago, it was Dayne in Ann Arbor, and it was all Michigan D, a capital D. They held him to 53 yards. Can they do it again? And in Madison, we're about to find out. It's Michigan and Wisconsin.
Last year, they led the league in sacks. They haven't had it yet so far.
The offensive line's doing an excellent job. If he can find receivers, Brady's got one. First down, Marquise Walker. Into Wisconsin territory. But I think, Gary, the point to be made here in the early going is that that Michigan offensive line is really keeping the front clean. Brady had way too much time. Brady to throw for it. All day. Receivers covered. Now it goes. Got it. Say, touchdown, Michigan. Way too much time, and there is a penalty. First down and 15 from the line.
No turnovers. Remember what Wisconsin can't do. We talked about it in the solutions of the game. Can't give any cheapies to Michigan. They're too good. This was self-inflicted, too.
Michigan's got it.
I don't care who we're playing, we can stand up there. He's a great alley fight.
And around, double reverse. Terrell's got it. Terrell swings 40. 30 on a cutback. Terrell, end zone, touchdown, Michigan. The double reverse.
Looking up for the coaches. Second down and 8, and Kavanaugh going to put it up again. Down the middle, got a man wide open, and hits Chambers for a first down at the Michigan 20 yard. Two tight ends and no fullback. Chambers in motion. Howard goes with him. Kavanaugh gets time. Fumbles one wide open. Touchdown! Oh, my! Oh, he dropped the touchdown pass. Chris Chambers. Field goal for Wisconsin. And instead of 7, they settle for 3. Play fake to cross. Hinson got time. Complete and a beautiful rocket right there to the 22-yard line. Folks, that's a big one. The 36-yarder. Free ball. Hand it off. And Wisconsin will put it in play right there. That was Jamar Fletcher. Here's the handoff to Dayne. Dayne breaks it again. He's still on his feet and he goes for the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin! Oh, what a great Dayne run that was! Kavanaugh gets time, goes Davis, intercepted. Whitley picks it off. Down at the turn. Bacchus on the other side. Now Brady got one on one. Watch Terrell against Fletcher. Up goes Terrell. What a catch he makes! The duel, and Terrell beats him. He's in. First down at 10. Brady got one-on-one. Marcus Knight going deep. Got it! Marcus Knight makes a beautiful over-the-shoulder catch at the 26-yard line. Short drop, pump fake. Brady goes in zone. Got Johnson. Got it! Touchdown, Michigan!
Touchdown, Michigan!
Logan.
Diallo Johnson goes up for the Brady touchdown pass, and the quarterback controversy. Second down and 20. Brady fires, got to run on the foot race with Fletcher. Terrell is hit, and it's picked at the 45. What an interception.
From the shotgun, juggle, holding on as he was going down was Ahmad Merritt. And that's a first school program down there. Ballinger finds the open man, another first down. The clock is stopped. It's Chambers this time. And second down and 8. Ballinger dances left. Look at him run.
Oh, watch the clip. There's dives for the touchdown in the end zone. Got it. Touchdown, Wisconsin.
Coaching job that this man has done. Lloyd Carr and Michigan win it 21-16. That's our final score. Stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental post game. All right, there it is. Final score, Michigan 21, Wisconsin 16. Stay tuned now.
Come on, come on.
I see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, kill him, he's a hero. Get it to the kids, who the hell cares? One
Drew Brees has led Purdue to a 4-0 start and their highest ranking in 19 seasons. Heisman-like credentials single him out as the Boilermakers' best.
Brees rolls to the right. He hurdles, and he gets in. He somersaulted in midair.
Today, he performs on the Big Ten's biggest stage.
It's Michigan in the big house. No more to say.
Last week, Michigan's defense made a statement. Today, conference call number 2 as they try and spoil the coming-up party of another Heisman hopeful. On home turf, assistance awaits from over 110,000 of the Wolverine faithful, who know full well only one team will remain unbeaten and on course for the Big Ten crown.
Kennard and Dunnigan, the other DB.
Thomas again, and lost it on impact at the 36, and Purdue says they've got it, and they do.
George, very accurate, in fact, the most accurate kicker in Purdue history, and he sends that one through from 28 yards. So Purdue settles for 3, but it is the first points allowed. Waiting for him this month. Toss out, Marcus Knight. Two tackles broken, right past Beasley, up the side, inside the 20. Out of the split backfield, Brady again all day to the end zone for Terrell in the corner. Caught it, touchdown. From Brady to the 6-3, David Terrell in the corner. Michigan answers. Bad snap, you hardly ever see that ball, still loose, and all the way back at the 30, Brees stripped. And Michigan has it. He was looking away, next thing you knew it was by him. He almost had the recovery. Ball took it away, and now Thomas rambles. What a move in the secondary by Thomas. All the way inside the 25, they'll mark him out of bounds, though, at the 30. Yeah, I think they finally got it as well as they have since they went back to grass. Brady
on the roll finds Marcus Knight for the touchdown.
Big hit picking up the blitzing Lorzel and throwing on the run. A strike for Knight.
Marcus Knight.
Back to the A train. He got in. Touchdown. Anthony Thomas, Michigan opens it up to a 17-point lead. As well as they could have expected this first half to go until now. Thomas hit in the backfield again, fumbled it. It's about the longest unpiling process I think I've seen. And on the bottom of the bush, this 31-yarder is good, and they get at least 3 out of it, but
better.
Breeze deep for Sutherland, has it. Biddy Sutherland, 99 yards last week, takes this one 66 yards, and Purdue at last has it.
Herb on first downs most of the day.
They set up the screen for Shea. Aaron Shea gets a block and is finally brought down by
tight ends. Thomas again.
Off tackle, keeps the legs turning all the way to the end zone. Touchdown.
Didn't do that this time when he scored.
Reeves needing three. Intercepted. Larry Foote. Fake went to the freshman Askew. Wide open night. Has it at the 25. Spins away from Hawthorne. And is run down at the 10-yard line by Lamar.
Rated by Terrell. First down from the 10. First carry. Askew spins all the way to the end zone. Touchdown for the freshman.
Michigan all over Purdue. 38-12, our final. Coming up next on ESPN, the Residence Inn College Game Day. For Dave Bryant and Bill Curry, Dave Barnett, so long from Ann Arbor, Michigan, 38-12, our final.
The shoe in Columbus is full today. The shoes next to me filled by my partner, Dean Blevins, and Barry Alvarez tells us his redshirt freshman quarterback is going to be the man today.
That is big news that you came up with. And, you know, Brooks Bollinger is the guy that, I guess Barry Alvarez is going to have that knee replacement surgery. He only hopes that his quarterback replacement surgery is not as painful as that's going to be. I mean, this guy, Brooks Bollinger, is going to be a star. I like him. He is a tough kid. But it's a tough place to debut. I played in this stadium, and it is tough for a young kid. He's a redshirt freshman. He's a good thrower. He's very mobile, so he has the tools. His job today is to have enough success to open up the running lanes for a guy named Ron Dane.
Well, Ron Dane was shut out by Michigan in the second half. They don't want that to happen here in Columbus today. And Ohio State with that high-scoring offense. Lynn Swann, they want to put some points on the board and do it early.
Well, you know, you talk about stopping Ron Dane, and what you have to do is obviously tack him deep before he gets your head of steam. But the best way to stop him is for the offense to score and score early. Now, that said, it's not been an easy thing for the Ohio State Buckeyes. In all four games, they have trailed. They have only had a lead once going into the second half of the football game. You've got to put pressure on them, force Wisconsin to throw the football. And you know why? Well, I know you know why, because Ron Dane has zero catches as a receiver. When they're behind, it's tough for them to
down catch. And six. Bollinger's first pass, slant, first down. Nope, in and out of the hands. Are they going to call it a fumble? Yes.
First and goal at the 9.
Nice play fake, and now Balasari comes out running again inside the 5 and down to the 2. They'll go straight ahead with Wiley, dives and fumble. And Wisconsin's got it in the end zone. Wiley went airborne, was hit in midair. And the fumble recovery in the end zone.
Kadorji, a great attacker. He does it here. That's the only way to keep points from being put on the board by Ohio State. Kadorji
to bail out of those situations. That's not his personality. Here he is on play action. Throws a rocket to Reggie Germany. Down to the 23-yard line. Second down and 6. Wiley, does he want to throw off this? He does. Wide open, Wisniewski. Down to the 1-foot line. Pick up of 17 on the halfback option. For it to make the grab inside the 1, where Wiley does the rest. Touchdown, Ohio State. The Badgers 48 end around. Kenyon Rambo, the convoy in front. Rambo inside the 40, down the sideline. Run out of bounds at the 20-yard
field goal attempt. Keep in mind, Belisari is the holder. He'll spot it down at the 25.
Stoltz. Got it up and good. The 40-yard line at 2nd and 6. Belisari wants it all for Germany. He's got it. Touchdown. A 42-yard attempt. Pasetsky got plenty of leg into it. And got it to give this guy. Let's see if he takes a shot at the end zone. Going to throw the deep out. Got his man. First and goal. It's a 25-yard field goal attempt. From the right hash, Pasetsky up, and
we'll have the ball first to start the third quarter. As Pasetsky's kick will take Wiley a yard deep, Michael will bring it out to the 15, fumble,
and I think the Badgers have it.
First half, did not have a good first half. He's in there behind Coons. Here he comes, Dean, to the end zone, touchdown. on a two-point conversion. Bollinger in and out of the hands of the intended receiver right at the goal line. It was a mile. Gonna have to hurry. Got the play off. Dane, left side. Touchdown, Wisconsin. They'll go for two again with a one-point lead. They'd like to stretch it out to three. Two tight ends set, and Ahmad Merritt in motion. They play fake it to Dane. They come up throwing. Coombs, did he get there? No. Great play by Percy King and Ahmed Plummer. He couldn't have been more in the saddle in that backfield. They fake it to him, and Belisari rifles it to Rambo on the run. Inside the 40 and down to the 34-yard line. And number four finally gets loose for the first time. 7-yard kick. And he's got it. And that was an important field goal because it stretches the lead down three. First down. Play fake to Dane. And here's Coombs, a fullback. And Coombs down the sideline, takes a couple people with him, and he's all the way down to the 13-yard line. Dane. By 11. Belisari steps up, fires. Wiley out of the backfield on a run. Michael Wiley out to the 45. For Wisconsin. Blitz coming. Dane going. Rondé, open field. One man to beat. It's Percy King. He got him, but not until he got to the 2-yard line. Second and goal, Wisconsin. Eddie Faulkner. Touchdown, Badgers. Went airborne. Kind of a maligned back. Has not had a great season. Had a pretty good game against Cincinnati. The second half. Belisari. Deep middle. Had it tipped, and it's intercepted by Myers. Bobby Myers coming back the other way. Myers breaking tackles inside the 30. Bobby Myers. He's going to go, maybe. All the way down to the 3-yard line. Dane's got three touchdown runs today, 60 on his career. Another chance here. Touchdown, Badgers. Is that eight straight scoring drives for Wisconsin?
I don't think they've been stopped.
Eight straight scoring drives. And Dane does the honors from the two. That's going to do it. Ohio State had a 17-0 lead with 10:23 to go in the half.
They saw Huey said, two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. I got love for my brother, but we can never...
The war that those superstars of 42 previous matchups in this series, the war almost began about 15 minutes ago. This was the scene at Doug Campbell Stadium before the teams headed to the locker room. They get set for the
six as the sunshine comes out. Black! Near midfield, it'll be Florida State
from the 48. Winky
sets and goes deep. Man out there and got him. Florida State touchdown. Jermaine Stringer.
They're going to keep it on the ground, play it safe, and it's Jackson in the open field across the 40. Jackson down the sideline. All second down and eight. Just outside the Seminole 25. Nice play fake by Kelly. Pumps once. Marks down the sideline, and he's got it. On the eighth play of their drive, second and goal, a fade to the corner. Caught, touchdown, Reggie Wayne. Third and goal at the three. They'll keep it on the ground, and it's a touchdown. Play action. Kelly throwing deep for Moss, and he's got it. Santana Moss breaks the tackle. Forget it. He's gone. Touchdown, Hurricane. Crosses the field. Kelly rolls that way. Pump fakes and lost it to the end zone.
Moss for the touchdown.
They got the playoff. Wenke rolls and throws on the run. Completes it. With three wideouts. Wenke pumped once. And lost it, and it's caught. It's six in a row on third down. It's third and nine here. Wanky to the end zone. Tight end touchdown. There's some room to work now for Florida State. And it's Meyer who breaks the tackle into the secondary. Travis Miner, 40, midfield. Got some blockers, cut back. Another blocker inside the 25. Travis Miner. Oh. All by himself. Gonna roll to his left. Now fires on the run, and what? For the Canes, trailing by three. Kelly, play fake, scrambles. Wide open is Moss over the middle, puts a great move on, and then out of there, at least that's what they give you, but it's play action, and it's Kelly to Moss.
Oh, what a wonderful route.
Out of bounds. They fake the pitch to Miner. Here comes the heat from the corner. Wanky somehow got away. In and out of the hands, and now caught. He'll be able to beat Florida State as a head coach. He's 0 for 4.
Here's a quick slant. Dugan cross field, across the 40, 50, down the sideline is Dugan.
First and goal at the 2.
Travis Miner, touchdown Florida State.
Diminishing his effectiveness that he had in that first half. And he needs some more magic back right now.
Kelly, hit as he throws. Completes it. Kelly steps up past the pressure, fires, tip.
Kelly, final play, and the throw is complete, but the game is over.
Next college football doubleheader concludes with regional action. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com.
Here I am in the place where I come let go. In Miami, the base and the sunset low. Every day like a Mardi Gras. Everybody party all day. No work, all play, okay? So we sip a little something, lay the rest to spill. Me and Charlie at the bar running up a high bill. Nothing less than ill when we dress to kill. Every time the ladies pass, they be like, can y'all feel me? All ages and races.
The war that those superstars of 42 previous matchups in this series, the war almost began about 15 minutes ago. This was the scene at Doug Campbell Stadium before the teams headed to the locker room. They get set for the
as the sunshine comes out.
Blocked! Near midfield, it'll be Florida State football.
From the 48, Winky
sets and goes deep. Man out there and got him. Florida State touchdown. Jermaine Stringer.
They're going to keep it on the ground, play it safe. It's Jackson in the open field across the 40.
Jackson down the sideline.
Second down and 8. Just outside the Seminole 25. Nice play fake by Kelly. Pumps once. Walks down the sideline. And he's got it. On the 8th play of their drive. Second and goal. A fade to the corner.
Caught. Touchdown. Reggie Wayne.
Third and goal at the 3. They'll keep it on the ground. And
it's a touchdown.
Play action. Kelly throwing deep for Moss, and he's got it.
Santana Moss breaks the tackle. Forget it. He's gone. Touchdown, Hurricane.
Crosses the field. Kelly rolls that way. Pump fakes and lost it to the end zone.
Moss for the touchdown.
They got the playoff. Wenke rolls and throws on the run. Completes it. With 3 wideouts, Wenke pumped once. And lost it, and it's caught. It's 6 in a row on 3rd down. It's 3rd and 9 here. Wenke to the end zone. Tight end touchdown. There's some room to work now for Florida State. And it's
Miner who breaks the tackle into the secondary. Travis Miner, 40, midfield. Got some blockers, cut back. Another blocker inside the 25. Travis Miner.
All by himself. Going to roll to his left.
Now fires on the run, and what?
For the Canes, trailing by 3. Kelly, play fake, scrambles.
Wide open is Moss over the middle, puts a great move on, and then
out of there, at least that's what they give you, but it's play action, and it's Kelly to Moss.
Oh, what a wonderful route.
Out of bounds. They fake the pitch to Meyer.
Here comes the heat from the corner. Wakey somehow got away. In and out of the hands, and now caught.
He'll be able to beat Florida State as a head coach. He's 0 for 4.
Here's a quick slant. Dugan's cross field, across the 40, 50, down the sideline is Dugan.
First and goal at the 2.
Travis Miner, touchdown Florida State.
Diminishing his effectiveness that he had in that first half, and he needs some more magic back right now.
Kelly, hit as he throws.
Completes it.
Kelly steps up past the pressure, fires, tip, intercepted.
Kelly, final play. And the throw is complete, but the game is over.
Next college football doubleheader concludes with regional action. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com.
Real sweet faces, every different nation, Spanish, Haitian, Indian, Jamaican.
Spartan Stadium is sold out. A bowl-like championship atmosphere. 13 unbeaten teams remain in Division 1A. 2 of them are here today. A huge day in college football, and there's no better place to be than right here in Spartan Stadium for this one. The Wolverines and the Spartans coming up.
And
here's Burke, has time, looks out there, he's got Burris. Move the chains for Michigan State. Here's the flea flicker.
Burke looking deep. He's looking for Burris. He's got it. Burris at the 20. Plaxico Burris inside the 10. They'll mark it at the 1. He was working against James Whitley, a pickup of 68 yards.
But in a game like this, emotional game, no score in the game, you know it's going to end up probably being a big play that's going to turn the tide. You have a chance for anywhere from 5 to 10 big plays a game. Good job, play action. You have a good running game. You get the play action. You get the pitch back. This time, Burke keeps it inside the receiver. Burris doesn't even have to break stride. We saw a couple other passes where the receiver had to turn to the outside where Burke threw too far outside. This time, hits him right in stride.
So Michigan State comes in with the jumbo package. Looking for power football. The rules down here, straight ahead, no fair dodging. Duckett. Touchdown, Michigan State. Excellent field position that they need to take advantage of. Here they go again to the big tight end, McCoy. Ivory McCoy, still on his feet. McCoy all the way down to the 26. This has plenty of distance, and it's good. Officially a 43-yard field. Plenty of time for Burke. He's looking for Burris. Burris has a step and makes the catch. All the way down to the 25-yard. And they're going to Burris. He's got the catch. Burke has time. Looks into Scott. Scott's got the catch. Touchdown, Spartans. In here. Hansen steps up in the pocket, reloads, has it picked off. Eric Morris inside the 20 to the 17-yard line. It's third down and long for Michigan State. To the corner, Burris, touchdown, Spartans. Both clubs 2-0 in the conference, both 5-0, both highly ranked. Here goes Moss. Moss inside the 5, still on his feet. Touchdown to Juan Moss, the fullback for Michigan State. Third down and a long 9, almost 10. Bill Burke with time, throws. Who's he looking for? He's looking for Plaxico Burris. He's got it. First down, Michigan State. Oh, what an afternoon he's had.
Past Andre Rison today for the school record.
Well, today, Chevrolet's players of the game, Tom Brady and Plaxico Burris. Well, today, Chevrolet's players of the game, Tom Brady and Plaxico Burris. In recognition of their efforts, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. And beginning this year, Chevrolet will also donate $1,000 to the two high schools. That's Green Run High School in Virginia Beach for Plaxico Burris and Sierra High School in San Mateo, California for Tom Brady. What a game they played today. 34-31, the Spartans beat the Wolverines of Michigan. Once again, the final score, Michigan State 34, Michigan 31. Coming up next.
Black, white, Cuban, or Asian. I only came for 2 days of playing.
Running like I used to run the pass. I'm going to run and hit that hole as hard as I can. And that's what he's trying to do tonight on the first run.
Sacks as well for the Georgia Bulldogs. Second down, they need 7. Short drop and... They'll go from a shotgun formation with a player to each side. Quarterback draw. Touchdown, Tennessee. State of South Carolina, Hartsville. Third down. They need to take it out to the 31. Tennessee leads it 7-0. Pressure. That was Haynesworth who just ran by him, and now Carter running for his life. And Quincy does not go down. They thought he was going to slide in the first quarter. Short drop, pumped it once. Now going for the end zone. Wide open. Touchdown, Edwards. Well, we had talked about the quickness of that thing. Second time tonight that that's happened. Martin gonna run it. Has 5, 10, 15, slides down very wisely. It'll be first and goal, Tennessee. Third down and goal. Georgia's showing blitz, and here they come, and they throw the screen. Lewis at the 5. He will score. With a play action, Loft's got a man wide open at the 10-yard line, and it's caught by Stallworth.
To own this area of the field, the Tennessee offense.
Fakes it to Henry. Wants to run it. Got a blocker in front, and Martin will score. That was Neil Johnson, the big junior out of Nashville. Room and regroup. Can't give up anything right here. T. Martin deep over the middle. Got his man at the 22. David. Jamal Lewis. First and goal, Tennessee. Quarterback sneak and touchdown, T. Martin.
Tennessee's defense doing so well, the policemen are even over there congratulating them.
This will be the fifth punt for Kopp, and the ball too high, gathers it. And that's a safety. He recovered the high snap just inside the end zone line. And folks, the route is on. T on third down from the shotgun. And that one is going to be intercepted. Jamie Henderson wrestled down by Scott.
Not been there tonight.
Got this one complete to Greer.
Sure handed.
Patrick pass. At the 5. Tailback. He's 265. They fake it to him and a pass. Caught for the touchdown, Johnson. So Georgia shows that, hey, we're going to let you know what we're made of. We're not about to roll over. Trying to roll into the open side of the field, throws it incomplete. Get that offense going for a change. Third down and 4. Line to make is about the 47 and a half yard line. Pumped it once and threw it right into the arms of Henderson. And Henderson down the sideline is going to take it in for the touchdown. 49 yards.
Ron George is back in his football game on that play.
It started that way, Michael. From the 2, this is Leonard Scott. Leonard Scott, 98 yards. Has an unblemished record against the Bulldogs. One of his 3 daughters in hand. Final score, Tennessee 37 and Georgia 20. Coming.
Yeah. Shout out to Hogan City, man. You know what I'm saying? Hogan 4PL. You know what I'm saying? I put it to. Shout out my label, that's me. I'm in this bitch with TB. I'm in this bitch with 4Trey. I just pulled up me a A. Real nigga all in my face. 500 racks in my safe. 500 racks to the plug. What you know about showing love? What you know about pulling up? In Billy Chubb. Make these bitches